So I guess dig in. Bon appetit.
No, I don't mind coffee with apple.
Again, it's a bit salty to me.
This definitely makes me want to have a beer.
Oh my god, it's so spicy. I'm still recovering. I don't know what to say about it. Hi, this is Lou from RADII.
And I'm Elaine from RADII.
You're watching the first ever video edition of Chinese Takeout,
our series on the stories and histories of snacks, dishes, and restaurants here in China.
And today we're going to talk and eat the many fried chicken options available here.
Why are we doing that, Lou?
So I wrote an article recently about fried chicken in China, from Asian hulu-ji to KFC to Korean fried chicken to Chinese counterparts.
Wow, and we're gonna try them all?
Yeah, I guess so.
Ah, there goes my diet.
So now we chose three types of fried chicken. One, KFC from America, Kiltren from South Korea, Zhengxin Steak Chicken from China. Let's get it started.
Yeah, let's dig in. Okay, so Lu, we actually ordered two types of fried chicken from each of these restaurants, right?
Right. So we have spicy flavor from each brand, and also we have some special flavors.
All right, so let's try out the special flavors first.
Yes.
And the first special flavor from KFC is actually just their original chicken, right?
Exactly.
Which one is actually their original chicken? Is it the one on top?
That's actually a good question.
Yeah, I think it's the one on top.
Really?
Yeah.
Yes, I think
so. All right, so I guess dig in. Bon appetit. Yeah.
It's a little bit salty for me.
There's a lot to chew, actually. Maybe I'll take smaller bites. This is kind of like the flavor I remember growing up, but I'm actually from America, so maybe that's why I'm used to how much salt they put into things.
I think this is the hottest flavor actually in America, but actually in China, the spicy one is more popular.
Mm.
So Elaine, do you know, even if KFC only came to China in 1987, but now China has the most KFC shops in the world.
Mmm.
Okay, I guess that's all about the original flavor. Let's try the next one.
So now we're gonna try the Korean fried chicken, and the special flavor that we ordered for this one is the sweet kind. Probably basted in honey of some sort. They just call it fragrantly sweet, right?
Yes.
香甜.
Let's try it out.
Yeah. So Kyochan is actually kind of a famous Korean brand that came here maybe about 10 years ago or so?
Yeah, probably. Yeah, because during the days, especially in 2013, there was a very famous K-drama called My Love from the Star. It was so popular. I remember at the time I was preparing for my Gaokao, but everybody was watching that. I couldn't resist. So I just watched it a little bit, you know, during the break when I studied. In the show, characters were eating Korean fried chicken with beer. And they call it in Korean, chimek, which got it so popular, and a lot of Chinese people were trying to find chimek in China. And then, here you go, a lot of brands, chains coming to China, and now we're trying Kyochan.
I remember one crazy story from that time period was that somebody got so obsessed with fried chicken and beer that she ate so much she died.
Oh god, that's horrible. Hope we don't eat too much today.
But I would die for this chicken. No regrets.
It is sweet, but not too sweet, right?
Mm-hmm. No, this is delicious.
Mm-hmm.
But I like how it kind of just bastes the coating of the chicken rather than like puts it in like this gooey kind of sauce, because I've definitely had Chinese versions of Korean fried chicken here and they've like oversauced it. Wow, that was delicious. And now it's time for a guochao, right?
Right. The special flavor we have here is cheese. 爆浆芝士鸡排.
So explosive cheese.
Exactly.
Should I try ripping it in half?
Yeah.
Okay.
Be gentle.
I think the cheese might have congealed a little bit because it's a little cold. So maybe it's not super fair. Cheesy chicken. Oh, this one's a little sweet. Interesting.
I remember I chose the plump flavor.
for this one. So that's why it's sweet.
So what's the story behind Zhengxin? Was it from before or after KFC?
It was after KFC. It was open around 2000, but now it has the most chicken shops in China. Actually, it says on the box it has more than 20,000 shops across China.
Who's the guy on the box?
That is Huang Bo. He's a famous actor in China. For some reason, he becomes the ambassador for Zhengxin. And I guess that's one of the reasons that makes Zhengxin become more and more popular.
Oh, wait, I recognize him. He was from like that Stephen Chow movie with Monkey King, right? I think he was the monkey.
How do you like this chicken?
I mean, it's a very interesting combination of salty and sweet. It kind of reminds me of like all the movie cinema popcorn that they have here in China. I can take it or leave it, I guess.
Right. I mean, Zhengxin has actually four flavors. I ordered plum for this one, so that's why it's a little bit sweet. That one ordered spicy. And they also have two other options, which are cumin and pepper and salt.
So it's actually pretty simplified, that menu, right? I wonder if that's how they were able to like open 20,000 stores across China.
Apparently.
Yeah, but that's like 3 times more than the amount of KFC stores here in China?
Yes.
All right. Well, so we're done with the special flavors, and now we're going to do a little bit of a taste test between the 3 flavors that they all have. Spicy.
Yes.
So here's the spicy chicken from KFC. This is what the spicy chicken looks like from Kyochan. And then this is the spicy chicken from Zhengxin. All right. Which one should we try first?
Well, how about Zhengxin?
Okay, let's go with Zhengxin this time first.
It looks like popcorn chicken somehow. I actually like the part because it comes with smaller pieces. So it's easier for you to just, you know, dig in and take one bite.
And also share, I think.
Exactly.
This kind of reminds me of like the fried chicken that you would find in night markets.
Pretty much. Actually, a lot of their stores are next to the metro station. So it's like, you know, when you go on commute from office to home, it's just easier to buy one box.
I guess that's why they also include the stick so that you can just like
right.
eat on the way home without having to put on a glove. All right, what's next? Shall we mix it up and try the KFC?
The crust is crispier.
Yeah.
Again, it's a bit salty to me.
Maybe that's why I usually associate KFC chicken with hangovers. But I think what I like about KFC and a lot of other American fast foods that have been here for a while, they've definitely localized to the market.
For sure.
So, I mean, they have these options, obviously. But then they have like what, like egg tarts and Beijing kalya breakfast. All right, so the spicy Korean fried chicken is this one. And it looks like it's also been like more basted in a sauce than like powder spice.
Yes.
Okay.
Because Korean chickens are actually fried twice, so they're supposed to be more flavorful.
Oh, this one's definitely spicier than the other two. This definitely makes me want to have a beer.
Actually, the meat is not as tender as I thought.
Let me take a moment, get some water.
Sure.
Because this is spicy enough to make me sweat a little bit. Alright, Lou, so of the 3 spicy chickens we ate, what was your opinion on all of them?
Well, this Zhengxin one is definitely the easiest to eat and chew. Well, the Korean one, oh my god, it's so spicy, I'm still recovering. And the KFC one, I mean, I don't know what to say about it. How about you?
Well, okay, I think the KFC definitely had the tenderest meat out of the actual 3, I think. And I don't know, I know that you find it a little salty, but I've got my North American taste buds, and so I actually found it okay. I like that it was just like mildly spicy, like just a bit on the tip of your tongue.
Right.
The Zhengxin chicken, I do like the convenience factor of it. And it felt like it was more crust than it was chicken, to be honest. And then the crust, because possibly it's been here a little while, has been a little soggy. I don't know what it tastes like straight out of the fryer. And the Korean chicken, I think, had the most flavor. which also meant it had the most spice. But unfortunately, it wasn't very tender. Maybe it's that double frying like actually just made it really dry.
Maybe
that's why they include radishes to go with everything too.
Right.
So we're supposed to like eat some of this with beer and pickles. But yeah, that's it. What should we do with all this chicken?
Wow, that's a lot.
Yeah. Are you guys
some? Ooh. Would you guys like some? Well, okay, we'll deliver this to the rest of the crew, I think. And that's it for this edition of Chinese Takeout.
Thanks for watching.
Yeah.